The teams are Forbes High and Morley High. Neither team have made the grand final before, which will probably explain the huge crowd in attendance. The Forbes High School boasts some very classy experienced players with great representative credentials. The captain, Graham West, 14 stone 8, has represented New South Wales in 72 and 73, and it's his fifth year of University Shield. Jeff Williams, part of the famous 1972 under 16 Australia touring team to Great Britain, and also George Greenhold is the current New South Wales fullback in the open weights division. They have an average age of 17. Morley High School, a much younger team, with six players under 15 years of age. They have a very well-balanced side. Morley's gone down to the Forbes around about, say, 35, 40 metres out from the Forbes try line. He plays back to Greenhold. Greenhold spins it down to Cotter. Cotter goes to the blind side. Pick it up and play the ball to Greenhold. And Greenhold goes the blind side to Robertson. Robertson's been held in defence there by King and Brazier. Plays it back to Greenhold. Bring it out to Olsen. Olsen picks up West on the fringe of the ruck. Tries to get a pass away. Loose ball on the ground and dived on by the Morley team, would say, knock on. Scrum to pack down. Fed by Olsen. The scrum screws around and looks like it's been dived on by Harry Allen. Harry to play the ball to King. King fires it away to Stephen Jones. Stephen Jones hits the fringe of the ruck. Stands in the tackle, passes out now to Terry Quinn. Terry Quinn makes a good pass down, stepping on the inside. He'll play the ball. He'll give it up there to Michael Duke, but the referee's found that Forbes inside the 5 yard. Kick for the sideline, a run around move, picks up Briggs. Briggs, good run by Briggs, but hit by a wall of defence and has jarred the ball loose, and Forbes come up with the possession. It's also to be remembered that for whatever reason, they use brand new footballs for the grand finals of University Shield. And so it could culminate in a few lost balls. They've hit the fringe of the ruck. It's gone down to the blind side. Let's move it down to Russell, the winger for Forbes. Steps inside there before eventually being claimed by Brown and Brazier. With assistance from Stephen Jones. They'll play the ball to Kirkman. Kirkman out to Olsen. Olsen out to McKenzie. McKenzie hits the fringe of the ruck before being brought down. Good tackle there by Harry Allen. He'll play the ball back to West. West out to Olsen. Olsen has a bit of a dart himself onto McKenzie. Can't make a break. Loose ball. It's going backwards and looks like it could be a knock-on. Scrum to feed by Olsen. Won by Harry Allen. Juggles the ball and decides to hang on to it. Dummy half is Brooks. Brooks will fire out to the apex side to Dean. Dean out to Quinn. Good run. Steps inside there to Terry Quinn, trying to find his big winger, Richard Brown, but he's been covered by the defence. Good tackle. That's one across there to, looks like Brooks hitting the fringe of the ruck again. Briggs in the dummy half, about 40 metres out from the Forbes try line. He'll spin it out, looks like, to Stephen Jones. Chucks a dummy and goes himself. 40 yards out. He'll play the ball back to Brooks. Johnny Brooks fires it out. It's gone out to Allen. Allen out to, looks like, Tony Dean, who's been smothered in defence by Williams. Peachy in the dummy half. He chucks a bad pass to Harry Allen, who can't handle it. And it's a knock on and against the Morley team. It's going to be fed. And Olsen has a run from dummy half. Finds McKenzie. McKenzie makes 1 or 2 metres, beating one tackle before being eventually claimed. Good tackle there by King. Dan Holt fires it away to Causer. Causer makes it to the halfway mark. He'll play the ball back. Kirkman spin dummy, has a run himself, passes out to Williams on the fringe of the ruck, who makes about 3 or 4 metres. Hook it up and he'll play the ball. Blindside move again, no dummies to the blindside and goes the open side, does Kirkman, the hooker for the Forbes team. He'll play the ball back. The scrum out to back line, out to McKenzie. McKenzie out to Olsen. Olsen out to Williams. Williams has a bit of a dart. Turns it back inside to the winger Holloway, who can't handle the ball. Scrum to back down, about 40 yards out from the Morley try line. He goes down the blind side. Penalty to the Forbes team in the kicking distance. Graham West will attempt this kick for the Forbes High School side. Moves in, puts the foot to the ball. Hasn't got the height of the length and drops short. Well fielded there by Tony Dean. Tony Dean runs it back. Good run upfield by Tony Dean, almost making to the 25-yard line. He'll play the ball back to Brazier. Brazier goes the open side to Briggs. Great run by Briggs. Briggs, 1, 2, 3, 4 players there, Briggs, before being eventually pulled down right near the 25-yard line. There's no mark and taps the ball forward. Good run there by Bernie Briggs. Good thinking as well. Makes another couple of metres for the Moree team. Plays it back to Stephen Jones. Stephen Jones sends it out to Allen. Allen out to Dean. Good crashing run there by Terry Quinn, who feeds it off to Greg King, who runs it down about 1 metre in from the touchline. Plays it back to Richard Brown, on to Johnny Brazier, and he's been hit by a wall of defence. Number 11 there, Robertson from the Forbes High School side. Plays it back to Brooks. Brooks out to Allen. Allen's got great tummy. Good pass by Allen. Chucks a long pass, but looks like the pass has gone astray, and Hadfield's gone back to jump on the ball, but looks like there's a loose ball, and it could be a turnover. Looks like a turnover to Forbes team. Kirkman in at dummy half. Cross down there to Pauza. Pauza makes a short break. Good defence there by Hadfield and Jones. That's out there to Kirkman, out to West. Oh, very uncharacteristic play there by West. Robbing that ball, scrum to back down. Harry Allen goes the blind side there. Looks like Olsen. Olsen feeds it on to fullback Greenhold. Back inside to Olsen. Olsen got rid of him. He picks up Greenhold. Great try there to the fourth team. That's the opening scores for the this afternoon's grand final. That's a try by Greenhold, who had it twice from the scrum base. It was a good try by the Forbes team. That's opening up the scoring to 3-0 to Forbes. West comes in for the kick, and the kick has gone astray, so it's the score remains at 3-0 to Forbes High in the 1973 grand final. The restart of play sees Dean put the ball deep back down into the Forbes High School territory. It's run back there by Noble. Noble being hit by Warner. Great tackle there by the big winger, Richard Brown. He'll play the ball back to Cotter. And it's gone back into the open side. Good defence there. West in the dummy half. West will fly down the blind side to Cotter. Cotter stands in the tackle. Can't make any more yards. Good defence there by the Moree team. Plays the ball back. It's gone now to the blind side again. Peppering the blind side. Looks like Forbes has gone across the back down to McKenzie. McKenzie chucks a wild pass there. Can't be held there by their fullback Greenhold. It's gone out to the winger, and it looks like it could be a loose ball and knock on. And that's a feed to the Forbes High. It's been won by Moree. Harry Allen. A fires away at the blind side there. Terry Quinn's got room to move. Tries to get out there. Had the big winger Richard Brown, but couldn't get in the ball. Good defence there by Graham West, hanging out in the centres. Obviously been put there to mark Terry Quinn. Big Richard Brown comes in from the blind side. Good run there, Richard Brown. Around about 2 to 3 metres out from the Forbes try line. Dummy half is Brooks. Brooks looks each way. Goes to the open, passes out there to Allen. Allen fires a pass out. And a very difficult pass there, couldn't be held. And it's Forbes High School has been adjudicated left side. Paul Peachy takes a kick and goal. It is successful. The scores are now 3-2 in favour of Forbes High School in the 73 grand final. Restart of play. The restart of play is a short run down to the blind side. It's been fielded, well fielded too, I might add there, by Bernie Briggs. Bernie Briggs runs it back. Greg King in the dummy half. Greg King fires it away to Stephen Jones. Stephen Jones, a loose ball. Scrum. Scrum's been webbed there. Run there by Harry Allen. Harry Allen out to Dean. Dean out to Quinn. Quinn's been smothered there by number 4, which is Williams for the Forbes team. Harry Allen in the dummy half. Harry fires it down the blind side to Johnny Brooks. Comes back inside. Good run by Brooks. Trying to offload. Can't do so. Big Michael Duke's in the dummy half. Michael Duke fires it away to King. King can't handle the ball. It's a knock on, as I said. With a bit of perspiration and pressure, the new balls are difficult to handle. They've gone down to the open side. Good run there. Good pass here by McKenzie, the 5-8 for the Forbes High School side. He'll play it back to Noble. Noble jostles around. Sorry, that was Cotter. Cotter passes off to Noble, who's been hit a couple of more defenders. He'll get up and play the ball to Kirkman. Kirkman fires it across there to McKenzie. McKenzie on the fringe rough, tries to turn it back inside, can't do so. Looking to offload on the outside, can't do so. They'll cover there the Moree team. Down to a short blind side, hit there by Causa. Causa will get up and play the ball. Back to Kirkman. Kirkman fires it out to McKenzie. McKenzie, a long pass out to Noble. Noble looks like he's put the ball down and it's been dived on there by the Moree halfback, Harry Allen. Out there by Brazier, out to King. King takes it up there. Good line there by Greg King. Hit by wall defense by the Forbes team. He'll play it back to Jones. Jones out to Bernie Briggs. Bernie Briggs, good offload. That's going out there to Hadfield, who turns it back into Richard Brown. Great run by Richard Brown. He's an absolute handful this afternoon. He'll get up and play the ball to Harry Allen. Harry Allen flies it up the apron side, long path. Looks like it's gone to Tony Dean. Tony Dean handles a difficult ball on the ground. Well covered up there by Tony Dean. Plays the ball back to Brook. Brooks out to Stephen Jones. Stephen Jones having a good game and everything here this afternoon. Peachy goes into dummy half. That's a long pass. It's gone out there to Tony Dean. Puts the ball downfield. Well fielded by Holloway, the wing. For the fourth time, makes one, two, and he beats three before being grabbed by the Moore defence. He's gone back out to McKenzie. McKenzie sends it out to there. It's Cotter. Cotter will make a run around about the 25 metres out from the fourth try line. They're going to have a bit of a scoot from the dummy half. Looks like, and looks like it's Wayne Olsen, the centre three quarter for the fourth side. He'll get up and play the ball. Swung out there now to Graham West. Graham West puts it downfield. Good long kick there by Graham West going down. And it's been out in the full, so it wasn't a good kick at all. And so the scrum will be fed by Olsen. Olsen had to McKenzie. McKenzie out to Williams. Williams steps inside, but then claimed by the Moore defence. Good defence there once again. It's gone a little run by dummy half there. Looks like Cotter. Cotter will play it back to Graham West. West fires it across. Oh, bad pass there by West. It's gone out to McKenzie. McKenzie on to Olsen. Olsen pick it up and play the ball. Good defence there by the winger. Ball back. It's gone out to the big front row, Robinson. Robinson makes a charge upfield, but Maury forwards up to the task. But Maury player has been hurt in that exchange. He goes across now, looking for runners on the fringe of the ruck. You play the ball back. It's gone out now to Kirkman. Kirkman hits the blind side. It's out to Robinson. Robinson's been playing 10 yards inside the Maury half. It's Olsen plays it out to McKenzie. McKenzie out to the other Olsen, who passes back into Cotter. Cotter makes a couple of yards before being claimed by Brazier and Duke. We play the ball back to Kirkman, dummy half. Spin dummy half again, goes across solid. There's Kirkman having a bit of a dart there now. Beach one or two, making a couple of yards, but can't find any runners. Forbes need to really be on their game here. The Maury side of starting the match in the forwards. Good run there, good stepping going there by Cotter. Peachy comes in here again and claims him. And the scoop from dummy half there by Noble. Good run, gets up, plays the ball. Dummy half fires it across. It's run across to McKenzie, but Maury high inside the five. Penalty kick by West is successful. The restart of play sends it down to looks like Noble. Noble runs it back. Good tackle there. Great tackle there by Johnny Brazier. With Johnny Brooks over the top. Good tackle there. Swings it out the open. It's going out there to number 10, Cotter. Cotter will get up and play the ball. Kirkman in at dummy half. Kirkman flies at the blind side there to Robinson. Robinson stands in that tackle. Good work there with the Maury side to cover up. Play back to Kirkman. Kirkman looking for runners. He passes out to McKenzie. McKenzie steps inside, goes a short line. Nowhere to run there, being claimed there by Stephen Jones and Bernie Briggs over the top. He'll play it back to Kirkman. Kirkman, a short pass there to Russell from the wing coming in, have a bit of a dart. Pick it up to play the ball. Plays it out to Kirkman. Kirkman finds Olsen. Olsen on the McKenzie. McKenzie on the West. West trying to pick up a player. The good defence. Still standing the tackle. Finds it back to McKenzie. McKenzie on the Kirkman. Kirkman makes a darting run. Trying to find some players. Number 11, Robinson's been claimed right on the halfway mark. He'll get up and play the ball. Plays it back to Graham West. Graham West will ride across there to Cotter. Cotter out there to Olsen. Olsen will find a way in there to Greenhold, the fullback. But a great coming tackle once again by Harry Allen. He'll play it back to Olsen. Olsen and the number 10 there, Cotter. Cotter puts a kick over the top there, well fielded by Tony Dean. Bernie Briggs in a dummy half. Briggs has a run to the open side. He's been well hit, great tackle there by the forward side. And the ball's been stolen. Oh, great try. Very unlucky there by the Maury side, but a good try there. Probably forced the ball by a good defence there from the forwards. And they've kicked the goal. So it's 10 points to 2 in favour of the Forbes high side. The scrum's been back down as one by Olsen. Olsen passes off McKenzie, but once again Harry Allen's underneath him, picks him up and drives him into the ground. The referee has found that the a forward passing movement, and it's a penalty. Dean takes the kick for the sideline. The Cardinals in there failed to find the touch there by Tony Dean, and the winger Russell wins back in the field. About 40 yards out from the fourth try line. West out to Kirkman. Kirkman having a run. Having a good game here this afternoon too, Kirkman. He's in everything. He'll play a ball back. It'll be spun across into Cotter. Cotter has a bit of run forward. Good run there. Well held by the Maurice side. He'll play the ball back. He's gone across now to number 7, Olsen. Olsen turns it back inside to Noble. Noble has a bit of a dart. Makes 1 yard inside the Maurice try line. They pass it across McKenzie. McKenzie will go outside there to Causer. Causer has been hit well by number 8, Stephen James, and driven backwards in the tackle. And the snacks on the mill here now, and Morey have got the ball. Get Duke in the bottom half. Duke fires it across to Bernie Briggs. Bernie Briggs has a good down run. Fires all, nearly got the pass away, but well covered up by the forward defence. Tony Dean with dummy half. Tony Dean passes it across there to Harry Allen. Out to Paul Peach, who steps inside, fires a good pass out to Terry Quinn. Got room to move. Beach 1-2. Proves an absolute handful here this afternoon is Terry Quinn, beating his first man on every occasion. He's touched the ball. Has gone off to King. Good run down the blind side there by King. Looks like he could be forced into touch or to play on. If play on more, he still had the ball. About 20 yards, 15 yards out from the Forbes try line. Pick it up and play the ball there. Stephen Jones in his dummy half. Pressure building here for the Forbes team. It's passed across to Allen. Allen shuts out the Dean. Dean and the Terry Quinn. Great busting run. Once again, as I said, Terry Quinn goes through, beats 1 or 2. Good run there by Quinn. He'll play it back to Briggs. Briggs fires the way to Dean. Dean passes out to Peach. He steps inside. 1-2. But can't get there. Perilously close. Only a metre short of the Forbes try line. Number 10, King in the dummy half, has a bit of a dart from the dummy half, but can't do any good, can't pick up a lane, and driven back there by Graham West from Forbes. Harry Allen, dummy half, pass out to Quinn, Quinn out to Hatfield, good run there by Hatfield, but nowhere to go there, well claimed by the fullback as well as the centre Olsen. Harry Allen, the dummy half, he'll pass it out there to King, King fires right across there, back to Quinn again, Quinn out to, looks like Stephen Jones, but no room to move. Dean with dummy half. Dean out to Brazier. Brazier had a little dart run. Chucks a dummy and fires away. Fires pitch on the outside. A fantastic try. Great run there by Johnny Brazier. His initial game in the University Shields coming up from around the 16 team. Finds a little half hole there. Chucks a dummy and found pitch. He quickly jumped on, put a move on the winger and scored the goal. Good try there by the Maori team, but good sustained pressure. And the kick of goal to come. And he kicks like a bikey in the world. And that's unsuccessful. And it's 10 points to 5 in favour of the Forbes high side. Restart and play goes deep down into Richard Brown. Richard Brown's been a handful for the Forbes team. Beat 1-2 again, Richard Brown. A big winger from the Maori side has been a handful for Forbes and causing all types of trouble. Knock on and a scramble back down. Fed by Olsen. Olsen fires it out to McKenzie. McKenzie out to the other Olsen. Olsen chucks a bad pass, but has come through and been claimed by Williams. Williams driven back there by Stephen Jones. It's gone across now to the middle there. Looks like it's the big middle. Williams has gone crashing through there, but great covering tackle there by Terry Quinn to bring him down. He'll play the ball back. It's spun out there to Cotter. Cotter makes a run down a short blind side. Absolute capacity crowd here at Graham Park. It's passed across here now to Kirkman. Kirkman finds West on the fringe of the run. He can't go anywhere. Good at tackle over the top. Underneath by Allen, over the top there by Briggs. It's gone out to the open side. It's passed now there, Williams. Williams, their representative centre, can't make any ground there, but Harry Allen hanging around grimly on the bootlaces. It's gone down the short blind side. He's trying to find Olsen on his outside. Russell in a dummy half. He'll fire it across. It's gone across there to Olsen again. The centre-free quarter Olsen. It's gone back down the blind side. It's out to Russell, the big winger. He's beat one, but come in and claimed by Brown. He offloads. And it's a good run there. Good attacking raid by Forbes. Mounting pressure about 10, 15 yards out from the Maury try line. It's fed there by Allen. Blind side move out to Russell again, peppering that side, but nowhere to go there with big Richard Brown. And also Brooks in the defence. Fired across the back line there. Greenhole comes in from fullback. Great tackle there by the fullback. Paul Peachy to bring him down 5 yards out. He'll play that to Cotter. Cotter out to Greenhole, steps and goes back inside. Still only a few metres out from the Maury try line with pressure mounting. He's going back to the open side. He goes out to McKenzie puts a kick over the top, and a good kick there, well claimed by Greg King, who gets back there and saves the day for the Maori team. Line drop out, it goes deep, and a good line drop, it goes out to the wing. Fielded by number 8, which is Noble. Noble gets up and plays the ball to Kirkman. Kirkman passes it back out to number 11, Robertson. Good run by Robertson. Been well stolen. Harry Allen saves the day again. Not only does he save the day with his defence, also steals the ball. It's gone across now to King. King chucks it on the inside. He gets it around about, say, 45 metres out from the Morley try line. It's gone to Dean, who fires it away to Bernie Briggs, who's stepping, swerving, going through. Great run by Briggs. Had a great game here so far this afternoon. Master Duke goes into dummy half. Faster, he passes it off to Stephen Jones, who floods the open side, trying to find some players in support. Can't do so. Good defence by Forbes. Johnny Brazier, dummy half. Johnny ducks a little dummy, has a guard himself, but nowhere to go, and then dragged back and lost a couple of metres. Bernie Briggs is down in the back play, but hit very hard, not defence by West. Peachy fires away to Quinn. Quinn fires along out to Brown into Russell, and looks like he could have lost the ball. It's come to pack down. And dived on by the Maori side, dived on there by Harry Allen. Played back to Brooks. Brooks fires it out to Dean. Dean out to Quinn. Quinn on to Peachy. Peachy gets a little joke. Great through. Cut through as Peachy. Good run. Chucks his feet. 1, 2, 3. Goes back out trying to find his winger. Chucks a parcel on the ground there. It's been claimed by his brother, but been pushed into touch. Probably just forcing the pass down in the first tackle. Peachy. Good run, but bring it all undone by the forced error. The scrum to be fed here by Olsen. That's been dived on by Harry Allen, and looks like it's a Maori win, I should say. And he plays it back to King. King fires it up to Brooks. Brooks darts to the open side. Good run there by David Brooks, but then crashed into, it looks like there's been a bit of a head clash there by two of the Forbes players. It fires across out to Jones. Jones out to Quinn. Quinn out to Peachy. Peachy's got room to move, but steps inside there. He's been claimed by the centre three-quarter of Bray Williams. Jones with a run to the apex line, chucks a bunny and goes himself near about a few metres out from the Maury try line. We'll play back to Harry Allen. Harry Allen juggles the ball, passes off to Bernie Briggs. Point put back ball to Peachy. Peachy got room to move. Oh, and it's a great pass, but very low and hard to take. But had that ball been taken, would have been a try. So bad luck. Difficult pass, low to the ground there, but couldn't result in the try. The restart of play, see Richard Brown taking it back, almost getting back. All he does actually, he gets over the halfway mark. Good run there by Richard Brown. As I said, an absolute handful for the Forbes defence here this afternoon. Good run to the open side. Forbes up in their face. Play the ball back to number 10, which is Greg King. Greg King will fight across out there to Harry Allen. Harry Allen has a little done. Once he breaks his week, 1, 2, 2, Harry Allen chucked it on, he beats 3. Beats 4. It's out to Michael Duke, great support by Michael Duke, who stands on offside, and of course he would be there, but Harry Allen, great run by Allen and Hughes. It's off to Michael Duke again, oh, good run, good support play there by the big fella, number 11, Michael Duke. Terry Quinn in the dummy half, Terry Quinn fires the way out to, looks like Brooks. Brooks, good run, number 10, sorry, King. King will play back to Dean, Dean will fight out there to Terry Quinn. He's only 3 or 4 metres out from the Forbes try line. Maury 10-5. That's the half-time score. Forbes leading Maury 10-5 in the grand final of the University Shield 73. I see the Forbes side attempt to pass through the Forbes, and I think the back line of Maury has been kicked back down there, brought back by the Maury side. There's a better change of possession. It's gone across to the centre three quarter went to Olsen, who juggled the ball and can't handle it, and so Maury in possession. He'll get up and play the ball. He'll play the ball to Brazier. Brazier will fire it and just has a bit of a run. And he'll pass back now to Harry Allen. Also Terry Quinn. Terry Quinn finds Stephen Jones. Stephen Jones will adjust and run. Offloads to Dean, who's been a medical claim as all the fourth players waiting for that pass. And Williams goes down now to Greg King. Good blindside run by Greg King. Passes back inside to Peachy. Peachy has a little bar run. Beach 1 or 2. Good run. Offload to Michael Duke, who in turn offloads. Again, good there passing exchange. But looks like the ball's been stolen there by the Forbes team. And they're in possession. Kirkman in the dummy half. Kirkman will fire it away to Robertson. Robertson stands in the tackle. And they're around about, say, 45 metres out from the Maury try line. Kirkman in the dummy half. Kirkman fires out to West. West a long pass. back out to Olsen. Olsen finds William on the outside. Has a bit of a dink. Gets around his opposite man. He pans out there to Holloway. Holloway down the blind side. Good raid there by the Wolves team, but it's all coming out to him. He brings it back about 20 yards out from the try line. And he'll get up and play the ball to Briggs. Briggs finds the way to the ever-present Harry Allen. Having a whale of a game here this afternoon is Harry. He'll play it back. It's spun out there by Quinn, sorry, to Quinn, and it's a big pass out there. And it looks like Terry Quinn, the captain, will play the ball. He's spinning out to, looks like Brazier has a bit of a darting run out to the open side. Tony Dean in the dummy half. Tony Dean will fire it away to Brooks. Brooks steps in, good run there by David Brooks. Pops an inside pass back to Tony Dean, who makes another 4 or 5 metres. Good run there by Johnny Brooks. Plays back to Harry Allen. Harry Allen will fire it out to Stephen Jones. Finds a bit of room to move. Hit high, great pass there by Jones. He finds, looks like it was Terry Quinn, and he gets over the halfway mark. Good offload, but last tackle. Scrum feed and to be fed by Olsen, the halfback for Forbes. He'll put the ball in the scrum. He goes down the open side. It's got a big centre three-quarter. Williams makes a 5 or 10 yard bust. Good rush by him. Good defence by his opposite number, Terry Quinn. It's out now to Potter. Potter fires off to, looks like Russell. Russell makes a bit of an inroad into the Moree side. Gets up and he'll play the ball back to Noble. Noble will fire it down the open side back to Kirkland. The hooker, he'll get up and play the ball to the halfback, Olsen. Olsen goes the open side. It's fired across their back line. He goes out there, looks like West on the fringe of the run. He'll get up and play the ball, but there's a loose ball. It's going to be more in possession. They fired across their back line. And Quinn's been brought down around about, say, 40 metres out. He goes out there to the big winger. Big Richard Brown comes back inside. Beats 1-2. Good run again by Richard Brown. Richard Brown to play the ball. It's gone back to Hadfield. Hadfield out to Briggs. Briggs out to Stephen Jones. Stephen Jones finds Bernie Briggs back up. Beats 1. Offloads off to Brooks. Brooks out to Brazier. Brazier out to Allen. Allen loose pass to Dean, but reclaimed and knocked back by the referee. And good recovery there by Tony Dean. He'll get up and play the ball back to Johnny Brooks. Johnny Brooks will find across to Allen. Allen out to Jones. Jones out to Quinn. Quinn finds Peachy, the fullback, making a bit of ground upfield. Flick pass inside of his brother, Peter Peachy, who offloads to, looks like Greg King being claimed by a wall of defence by the Forbes. Good break there by the Moree side. Starting to gain a bit of problems in the back line. Johnny Brooks goes to the blind side. Passes back inside. Harry Allen. Harry Allen out to King. King's been hit, offloads out to Johnny Brazier. Good run there by Brazier. That's the last tackle. Referee with his hand raised out to Allen. Allen fires it across there to Briggs, out to Tony Dean. Tony Dean puts a high Gary Owen up. Good kick there by Dean. Plenty of pressure. It's gone out there, reclaimed by the Warriors side, but last tackle is Forbes. Never touched the ball, so it's a scrum to pack down. Only about 5 yards. Scrum win to Forbes. Oh, rushing off their try line. Good defence there again by the Moree side. Jarring the ball loose and looks like a turnover. And this could be a chance for the Moree team. The referee has found a penalty in there. Apparently the ball was flaked. So Forbes and West take a tap kick and they offload to Robinson. Robinson will play the ball to Kirkman. Kirkman fires it out the open side. And it's gone out to, looks like they're back to Cotter. Cotter will get up and play the ball. Back to Kirkman. Kirkman fires it out to Noble. Noble claimed well on the tackle by, looks like they're Stephen Jones. Kirkman fires across to McKenzie. McKenzie out to Olsen. Olsen being claimed well. Good tackle there by Bernie Briggs. He'll get up and play the ball to West. West will fire out there to McKenzie. McKenzie finds Williams. Williams back inside to McKenzie. He's stepping around, swerving. Actually, it was Olsen, the halfback. He's been claimed well there by defensive Jones and also Dean. He goes off down to the blind side, tucking dummies, running through there, trying to pick up some players for the Forbes. We'll play the ball back. Kirkman fires across to McKenzie. McKenzie out to Olsen. Olsen to Williams. Williams on the green hole. So that's the winger, Holloway. Holloway passes it back inside, but it's a loose ball and Moree got it. No, it's a changeover. And it's gone back to the Forbes team. And the big centre three-quarter, sorry, that was number 11, that was Robinson. Running down about 5 metres for the Forbes team. Going out to West, inside pass to Cotter. Cotter looks like he's lost the ball and and by them and by Harry Allen. Knock back and bang on to the Maori side. Going out for Brazier. Brazier out to Jones. Jones out to Dean. Dean fires a long pass out to Quinn. Stepping inside. Once again, a handful is Terry Quinn. He finds one of the Maori, Tony Dean, backing up the support. Good one there by Dean. Good play back to Quinn. Quinn shuts a long pass out to Stephen Jones. Stephen Jones puts a kick through. Peachy's on the chase there. Parry. And Parry through. Good run there by Peachy. Regathers and try. And it's Maury back in the grand final of the University Shield 73. Late break there by Stephen Jones and a good kick. And the Peachy carried through and regathered. The kick to come and they've been unsuccessful. And 4-5 still lead. That's 12 points to 8 in the grand final of the 73 University Shield. Pressure mounting, and Maury need to get the next points on the boards as well as time is ticking away. Good run there by the Forbes High School side. And Kirkman in the dummy half. Good run there by Olsen. Kirkman spins it out. It's going across there to West. West chucks the dummy and goes back inside. He'll get up and play the ball to Kirkman. Kirkman looking for his plays. Chucks a little dummy and goes himself, does Kirkman. West in the dummy half, he'll fight across to Olsen. Olsen out to McKenzie, McKenzie onto Olsen in the centre. Looking for Williams, can't do so, and it's being jumped on and claimed by the Maori side. Thunder back down, and it's been won. That's attacking Ray there by Forbes. And it's out to their big centre, Williams. Williams will play the ball. Russell will have a little run from dummy half. Good run there, Russell. Knee busting through there, but good tackle by Peachy. And Jones to bring him down. To play the ball to Kirkman. Kirkman out to Olsen. Olsen out to McKenzie. Tied up his fullback. Greenhold steps through. The New South Wales fullback. Open weights nearly got through there. Good run. And it's been dived in by Michael Jukes, but the referee has adjudicated that he was in front of the play of the ball. And there's a kick to come. And that makes it 12 points to 8 in the favour of the Forbes High School side. We start a play. It's going deep, good kick there, found the winner Holloway. He'll run it back upfield. He's been absolutely smashed there by the wall of defence on the Maori side. Kirkman in the dummy half. Kirkman fires it away to, looks like, Robertson. He's been picked up and thrown to the ground there by Howie Allen with some assistance from Stephen Jones. Plays it back to Kirkman. Kirkman out to Olsen. Olsen tried to find up. He's the centre partner, Olsen, as well. Number 10, King, a play back to Dean. Dean will fire it away now to Peachy. Peachy comes in, fires it out to Stephen Jones. Stephen Jones finds Paul Peachy, who tries to step inside, but being claimed by the Forbes defence. He'll get back and play the ball to the replacement in the Dawson. Dawson out to Breeden. Breeden will find Harry Allen stepping. Still going, Harry Allen. Good run by Harry Allen to make something out of nothing. He'll play the ball back to Briggs. Briggs fires out to Johnny Brazier, chucks a little dummy out to Peter Peachy, who cut through, beats 1, 2, 3, good, standing in the tackle, passes offload, offloads to Perry Quinn, Buster Duke, kicks out the open side, the trainers are hot out there to Johnny Brooks, that's a try, we're back in the game, Maury High School are back in the game at 12-11 with the kick to come, been taken by Bernie Briggs, and it's 13-12, the time ticking away, Maury have finally hit the front in the 73 grand final. It's a big kick down the Maury side, being fielded there by Stephen Jones. Little jinking run back upfield, good run there by Jones. He'll get up and play the ball, about 40 metres out from the Maury try line. It's Brooks. Brooks will fire it away there to King. King chucks it up the inside. Gets up and plays the ball, looks like Quinn. Quinn out to King again. King's, oh my God, they say he hits that hard, he can change the DNA. Well, that's a perfect example. It's a great hit there by Graham West. He'll find Peachy. Peachy floats a ball across there to Dawson. Dawson hits hard in there. The referee's found there's something wrong with that. Either a knock on or a forward pass, and there's a scrum to pack in. Olsen to feed the scrum. It's gone out one by Harry Allen. Out to Tony Dean. Tony Dean out to Quinn. Quinn out to Peachy. Coming up from fullback. He finds his brother Peter Peachy. Out to Richard Brown. But Randy moves on the outside. Good run there by Richard Brown. Perilously close to the sideline. Peachy in it there at dummy half. He'll fire it across. It's gone across there. Bad pass there. And it's been, looks like it's been lost. And but a penalty issued as the forward player was offside. And so it's a kick for touch. And the Maury now in possession. Across to Allen, Allen out to Dean, Dean out to Quinn. Once again, go through the first line defence. Great game here this afternoon by the captain, Terry Quinn. Allen, Allen off to Stephen Jones, Tuxedani. Good run there by Stephen Jones. Pick it up and play the ball to Greg King. Greg King will fire it across. He goes out to Peter Peachy, little stepping run, stands in the tackle again. Passes off to Jones, Jones out to Stephen North, who loses his footing. And it looks like he's lost the ball, but apparently for raking out infringement. That's a runner hand. Oh, great pick pass by Harry Owen to Buster Duke, who's off. That was a good move there by the Maury side. A sleight of hand by Harry Owen. The big punt down on Michael Duke. He goes across the ground on loose pass from the ground. Harry Owen dived in it, but it looks like it's a knock on. Forbes won the ensuing scrum, and they're trying to run it off their try line, about 5 metres out from the Forbes try line. To play to Kirkman. Kirkman has a little bar from Dummy Hard. Good tackle by King. To play the ball. It's gone across there to Greenhold. The fullbacks come in for a run. They try to give the forwards a rest and get them off their try line. Pick it up and play the ball back to Kirkman. Kirkman fires it out to McKenzie. McKenzie inside to West. West beats a cover tackle. Fires back out to Noble. Looks like it could have been a drop ball. No. Referee says not. He'll get up and play the ball back to Kirkman. Kirkman fires a spin running half down the open side to Cotter. Cotter will get up and play the ball. He'll take it out to Kirkman. Kirkman out to West. West tucks a long pass out there to Noble. Noble had a bit of a run there, trying to look for it. He sent it apart and Williams can't find him. Good tackle there by Dawson. It's going to be fed. It's been won by Olsen. Olsen out to McKenzie. McKenzie's lost the ball in the tackle and looks like it could be claimed by the Maury team. It has been done by Tony Dean. Tony Dean out to King. King finds Peachy on the outside. Good run there by Peachy. Even though hit by a wall in the fence. Quinn out to Allen. Allen loose pass on the ground there. Picked up by fullback Paul Peachy. He gets up and plays the ball to Harry Allen. Harry Allen fires it out to Tony Brooks, over a good run as well. Good run there by Brooks. He'll get up and play the ball. Round about, say, 40 metres out from the fourth line. Briggs spin running half out to King. Takes a little down the inside. Back out to big Buster Duke. Buster Duke, beautiful pass on the inside there to Dawson. He'll get up and play the ball, time ticking away. It's a juggle from Dummy Half. It's going to have to be Briggs got room to move. Oh, absolutely nailed by Graham West. You'll see more stars than Bill Collins with that one. Peachy on the open side. Jackson did nothing, goes through. Might have been some room on the outside, but not worth the risk. Boring in front. Good kick there by Peter Peachy as the up and under. Good little kick there, and it's going in the crowd. Time ticking away. Not long to go now. And Ford Fire still have got a big lead if they're going to win this one. The restart of play sees us about 2 yards in from the sideline. Forbes has been into Cotter. Cotter has been brought down near the halfway mark. He'll play it back to the dummy half, Kirkman. Kirkman will fire it across now to McKenzie. McKenzie stepping inside, can't find any players. Pick it up and play the ball back to Kirkman. Kirkman looking for some runners, trying to urge his players on. He's fired across there to Robertson. Robertson gets up, plays the ball to Kirkman again. Kirkman has a little scoot to the open side, trying to pick up some players, and he finds Noble. Noble will get up and play the ball back to Kirkman. Kirkman goes to the open side. It goes out to Graham West, who puts up a high kick. It's gone down to the wing or the centre field. It's bouncing everywhere. A knock on both ways. Stunfeet then has been won by Forbes. Olsen has a bit of a dart from dummy half. Can't find his fullback in Greenhold. He'll play the ball back to Graham West. Graham West will fire it out to the line side. Number 6, McKenzie, makes little darting run, but it's a lost ball there. And Morley come up with the ball. Peachy the dummy half. It's out now to Johnny Brazier, who loses his footing. He'll make a couple of yards, Brazier. It's out now to Allen. Allen out to King. Fires it out to Bernie Briggs once again. Step off both feet and dummies. Beats a couple of those Briggs, looking for some players to offload to. Can't do so. Peachy, yeah, fullback. Runs the fullback and beats 1-2. Offload there to Terry Quinn. Good run by Peachy. Good support play by Terry Quinn. He'll play it back to Harry Allen. Harry Allen. There's a loose pass out there to Stephen Jones, but a judge though to be a knockback. It's a nice tackle. What can Maury do? Around that 40 metres out from the fourth try line. Brazier fires it away. It's a high kick. It's gone down and well taken there. Looks like it'll be fullback being held for Forbes and Good smothering tackle, great tackle there by Stephen Dawson, bringing down about 5 to 10 metres out from the Forbes try line. Hit by the ball. It's about the open side there by Holloway. Holloway, good tackle there. Beats one, but a great covering tackle there, bringing down by King. Bad pass there by the Forbes player. Looks like it was Kirkman. Kirkman plays it back now to West. West fires it away to Olsen. Olsen having a little batting run, but the Moore defence is up to the mark. He'll drop back and he'll play the ball. Time ticking away for Forbes. And it's a blindside move, a switch back there by West. West finds Olsen. Olsen down the blindside. Can't find him winger. He'll get up and play the ball. Around about, say, 30 metres out from the Forbes try line. He goes out. It's a pass back inside to Robertson. Robertson goes up the middle. Olsen defeats the scrum. That's a win by Forbes, but a penalty for feet in the scrum or feet up in the scrum. And it's a kick. Allen. Allen sleight of hand out to King. King puts an inside pass. They're off to, looks like they could have been Brooks. There's a run from the dummy half. And Dawson in the dummy half. Time ticking away. Has gone across now to Brazier. Brazier finds Harry Allen. Beats one hammer. Harry Allen, loose pass on the ground, being dived on, but knocked back for the Moree side. Time ticking away. Can Forbes get this? Can get bring it back to even Stevens? It's going back out now to Dean. Dean has a little step inside. He'll play the ball back to Peach. Peach will offload. Good run there by, looks like it was Johnny Brooks, and that's it. It's all over. And it's a 13 points to 12 win for the Moree side over Forbes High in the 1973 Grand Final. A great win to